Good man. Well, there's only 2 points in it, but the 2 points were in your favour, Michael. Both got it.
Back to winning.
And they deserve their trophy.
They did, it. Well done, lads.
Thank you, Michael.
You saved me there.
Thanks a lot.
Good stuff. Well done.
Excellent. And of course, you all get a You Bet medal as well. Tough luck. So I'm sorry about that.
It was a bad sign, I think, winning the trial runs this morning, but fair play to the lads.
But you're all right. Michael's not sorry at all. So not only do you not get a forfeit, but you also get 56 points. Let's see how the others did as well. Ross got no points at all. Poor showing there. Les gets 56 points. Well done, Les. And Keith got no points either. But our audience gets another 56 points to their credit. Well, thank you very much for your hospitality here in Ireland. We've had a great time. It's been a great pleasure, Michael.
Thank you, Michael.
Continued success.
That's right.
I hope we meet again. Well, that's it for part one. You take the high road and I'll take the low road. And I'll be in Scotland before the end of the commercial break. I'll see you in a bit. Ciao.
That lad's keen to learn fishing. And his mate wants to know how he can be more successful.
They'll both get a lot of help from The Art of Fishing.
It tells you all about fish and where to find them, with expert advice on what equipment to use, what kind of bait, and what kind of tactics. And people like me give you lots of useful tips.
Republished in weekly parts, The Art of Fishing is something you'll turn to again and again.
What a beauty!
Right now at QuickFit, you can buy tyres and exhaust at really low prices and not have to pay a penny. Until later. Can you afford to go anywhere else?
Introducing Bernard Matthews Honey Roast Norfolk Turkey Breast. Made from delicious roasted turkey breast with a touch of honey. Tender, tasty, and so lean it's 98% fat-free. Bernard Matthews Honey Roast Turkey. Give him a slice of Norfolk. Beautiful.
While some companies make you special offers from time to time, at B&Q, key DIY and the products you buy most regularly means low prices when you want them. That's all the time, every day. Key DIY at B&Q.
Indigestion? Tum, 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 tum. Settlers Tums express relief in three fruity flavors, blackcurrant, orange and lemon.
Throughout the day, your clothes pick up all sorts of dirt and odors. Ordinary big bottle liquids only get out ordinary dirt and can fade colors. New Radeon Color has a bleach-free cleaning system that tackles tough stains and odors without fading colors, giving a fresh, bright clean. Get more out. Put new Radeon Color in.
Even if your shares of Scottish mature cheddar vanish overnight, you can reinvest the next day. Make sure you get your share.
Discover the blues. The musicians. The mood. But above all, the music.
My baby beside me at the wheel.
Boom, 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 boom.
The Blues Collection. A new series from your newsagent. For just $3.99 on CD or cassette. Part one, only 99p.
I need authorization.
Eddie Murphy's back in Beverly Hills and back in deep trouble in the Scottish movie Beverly Hills Cop 2, Saturday 6:30 on Scottish.
Oh, my chain came off and I banged myself in the trussocks. Anyway, welcome to Scotland. Edinburgh, to be precise. Edinburgh, generally regarded as one of the most beautiful cities in Europe, famous for its festival, and in particular, its Fringe Festival, where never in the field of human culture have so few been entertained by so many with so little. Anyway, it's to Calton Hill we come for our third challenge. And this, believe it or not, is a hammer. And our next challenger, Alistair Gunn, is a hammer thrower. And he claims that with this hammer, He can hit three gongs placed at 25 metres, 30 metres and 35 metres, respectively. He'll get 10 goes at the gongs. Can he do it? Well, let's go and meet him and the man who says he can. Hi, Ross.
Hi, Matthew.
Hi, Alistair. Welcome. I think you'll find this is yours. Ross, do you have a connection with Scotland, or is it just the accent?
Just a touch, yes. I actually come from Glasgow, which is a small fishing village along the River Clyde. You don't know of it?
We know it well.
Yes.
Because somebody even more famous came from Edinburgh, didn't they?
Well, exactly. My name is Bond. James Bond.
I didn't know Roger Moore came from here. Introduce me to your challenger, Ross.
This is Alistair Gunn.
Excellent. Alistair, welcome to the show. And congratulations, because you have retained your World Highland Championship title, have you not?
Yes, thank you very much.
Right, and you're a specialist in the hammer?
Yeah, I'm pretty good at it.
I think that's just as well, as far as you're concerned, Ross. Don't you? A degree of accuracy will have to be shown during this challenge, but normally you just throw it for distance. What's the furthest you've actually thrown a hammer?
Well, yesterday, actually, it was 8 inches off the world record, which was 150 feet, 6 inches, and the record was 151 feet, 2.
Excellent. This is all going swimmingly.
I'm impressed.
So how difficult is this challenge for you?
It's very difficult because usually we have a sector we throw in and it doesn't matter where it, as long as it lands in the sector. But today I've got to hit targets, so it's very difficult indeed.
Why are you backing the challenge?
Well, I mean, look at those muscles.
Huge.
Look at those. Seen better muscles than a jar. I am backing this man because I can say in two words, this man has got exactly what it takes.
What's that?
That's it.
That's pretty. Good luck with it, Alistair. Ladies and gentlemen, our challenger, Alistair Gunn. OK, Ross, this is your challenge.
Yes.
You're going to have to face a forfeit if it fails.
Ah.
Let's see what Les thinks about it over in Jersey.
Well, I definitely think he's going to do it, as he is the world champion in the Highland Games. Definitely, yes.
What about it, Keith in Cornwall? Are you going to side with the hammer thrower?
I'd always side with the hammer thrower. No, actually, I think this is quite difficult because I know that it's a matter of distance, but there's a certain amount of emphasis on accuracy. I'm going to have to say, Matthew, he won't do it.
Thank you, Keith. All right, let's go over to Dublin. And Michael, do you think Alistair's going to hit his gongs?
I think so, Matthew. Yeah, I'm going to go yes this time because I've seen these boys throwing the hammer in the Olympics and they throw them an awful long way and they're very accurate as well, so it's going to be a yes this time.
Yes, very positive. Thank you, Michael. Well, this is three yeses and one no. Looking good.
Yeah, well, they all remember the old song. If I had a hammer, I'd take it out, swing it around my head and hit a few targets.
Yes, I remember it. Let's go and find out what the audience think. Hi, young sir. What's your name?
Bill.
Hi, Bill. Do you think the hammer thrower will do it?
Yeah.
Why do you think he'll do it?
Because he's the world champion.
Of course, I should have thought of that, silly me.
Right then, in the silly questions department, are you Scottish?
Yes, I was born here.
And what do you reckon? Is Alistair going to do it?
Oh, aye, no bother.
No problem at all?
No problem.
It's a big yes.
Hi, what's your name?
Sharon.
And is the hammer thrower going to do it?
Yes.
Is he going to do it?
I don't think so.
No? No? Oh, you're letting the side down here.
And will you side with the hammer thrower?
Naturally, I'll side with the hammer thrower.
Is this a case of the Scots just sticking together?
No, I think the lad's got talent.
Right then, Mary?
No.
Oh, Mary.
No way.
No way at all?
No way.
Why not?
It's far too far for him.
There, that there.
How'd you get on?
And I got a definite no, but I don't think that was concerning the challenge. That's how I get on.
All right, well, I got nearly a complete 50-50 yep. split.
Go on then, work it out okay, then. Come on, Kelly.
I need the calculator for this. All right, then it's a... I would say, roughly speaking, 67% say yes and 33% say no.
I agree.
Not bad odds. Well, it's all yours, Alistair. Good luck. Sure. Nothing personal, but if you need us, we'll be over there.
Well done, Alistair. There's your medal. You bet trophy as well. Didn't let Scotland down either. Well done.
Congratulations, Alistair.
A successful challenge and no forfeit!
Hurrah, hurrah, hurrah!
Ripple of disappointment there. Never mind. You can't be too disappointed because you get 67 points as well. Let's see what they get around the country. Les, over in Jersey, you get 67 points as well. Sorry, Keith, down in Cornwall, no points there. OK, Michael, well done in Dublin. You get 67 points too. And of course, our audience have 67 points to add to their score at the end of the show. Well, it's been excellent. Well done, Alistair.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Not at all, my pleasure.
We'll see you a bit later on. It's farewell to Bonnie Scotland and bonjour to the Channel Islands. I know what you're thinking. How on earth did Matthew get all the way from Scotland to Jersey so quickly? Well, think about it. It's downhill all the way. Right, well, we're here in Jersey, largest of the Channel Islands, with 20 miles of glorious sandy beaches. Jersey is famous for its Jersey cows, its Jersey potatoes, but paradoxically, not its Jersey jerseys. It's famous also for its flowers, and that's the subject of our next challenge, Flower Power. 15 girls from the 18th St. Helier Guide Group have already decorated the special You Bet float for the famous Jersey Battle of Flowers. And as you can see, it's almost complete. Their challenge is to create in flowers this You Bet logo on a board measuring 2 metres in diameter, then attach it to the front of the float. And they have only 2.5 minutes in which to complete this task. The girls will be using real flowers which have already been de-stemmed, ready for them to glue onto this board. The question is, can they do it in the time? Well, the man backing the challenge is the world-famous ex-girl guide and flower child, Les Hill. Ladies and gentlemen, Les Hill!
Thank you.
You are a popular chap, aren't you?
You were.
Just as well, because you're Mr. Battle this lot.
I am indeed, I am.
And what does it entail being Mr. Battle?
I have to escort Miss Battle everywhere.
Is that it?
Well, that's a lot, actually.
Just take a lovely lady around the whole time.
You're not exactly working, is it?
You don't know you're born.
Yes.
Introduce your challenges to us.
Well, this is the 18th St. Helier Girl Guide Group, and with me I have Vicky and Natasha.
Hi, Vicky.
Hello.
Have you ever entered a float in the competition before?
Yeah, we done it last year and the year before.
Did you win?
Yeah, we won first prize in our class and the youth awards.
Are you going to win with this float?
Yeah.
Yes. Action. So, okay, Natasha, you're using real flowers, aren't you?
Yeah.
What sort of real flowers are you using?
Chrysanthemum.
Okay. You still can't say it again. Say it again.
Chrysanthemum.
How long does it normally take?
2 to 3 days.
To decorate a float?
Yeah.
And you're going to do this in 2.5 minutes, are you?
You bet.
Oh, very topical, never. Well, I hope you've got time. How many flowers have you got to attach exactly, Vicky?
1,843.
Well, you better get started. Well, get your places, girls. All the best. Ladies and gentlemen, the 18th St. Helier's Girl Guide Group. And this is your challenge, Les.
It is indeed.
We're going to have to do a forfeit if we don't do it.
No chance of that at all. No chance.
No problem. Let's see what they think around the country. Keith, what do you think of the dexterity of these girl guides?
Oh, this is easy, Matthew. I'm going to say yes, because, I mean, these girl guides in Jersey, they must be very used to sticking flowers in mud. They're going to do it easily.
OK, Michael in Ireland, can the girls do it?
I think so, Macho, yes. My father always told me never to argue with a woman, so I'm not going to argue with 15 girl guides, so I firmly believe they're going to do it.
OK, Ross in Edinburgh, is it the girl guides for you?
Well, speaking as a former girl guide... No. No, sadly, I don't think the girls are going to do it. Dib.
Yes, thank you, Ross, and a dub to you too.
No faith, Ross.
Well, no, but that's only one no in the midst of three yeses.
Yes,
it's bad art.
That's pretty good, actually.
Well, let's find out what the crowd here think. Have you brought your calculator?
I have, actually, right.
Splendid.
Here.
Let's go out amongst the throng.
Let's.
Excuse me, sir, what's your name?
Ferris.
Ferris. Do you think they can do it?
Definitely.
You do?
Yeah, no problem.
How you doing? What's your name?
Scott.
Scott, where are you from?
New Zealand.
New Zealand?
Yep.
Close to home. Good on you, mate. Do you think the girl guys are going to do this?
Of course they will.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Excellent. Well done.
Can the girl guys do it?
No, I don't think so. I'm going to be very unpopular for that, but I don't think so.
Why not?
I think they've got too much to do in too short a time.
All right, who'll be getting it? What's your name?
Stephanie.
Stephanie, are you from Jersey?
No.
You're not from Jersey. Whereabouts are you from?
Basildon.
All right. Do you think the girl guys are going to do this?
Yeah.
Good on you.
How did you do this?
Well, the majority of people said yes.
Well, they did with me as well. In fact, I only had one person actually say no. So I'm going for a massive vote for you. I would say, roughly speaking, a massive 82% say yes. Excellent. And only 18% say no.
Excellent.
Well, it's up to you girls to prove the 82% right.
Come on, girls.
On your marks. 3, 2, 1.
Hey, guess what? I got a trophy for you here. Big You Bet trophy. You can take that, Vicky. And I've also got a medal, a gold
medal.
Everyone
gets a medal.
Everyone gets a medal.
Ladies and gentlemen, 18 St Helier. Come on! Well done, girls. Okay, well, there's major points going here. Not only do you not get a forfeit, but you get 82 points. Let's 82. See what everybody else gets around the country. And Keith in Cornwall, he said yes, he gets 82 points. Michael in Dublin, he also said yes, so he gets 82 points. And Ross, tragically, said no, no points at all there. And of course, 82 of our audience were right. Well, that's it from Jersey. Thank you to Les Hill, ladies and gentlemen. Well, that's it for part two. Join us again in a couple of minutes when we'll be showing you a version of Watership Down, hitherto unseen. OK, stand clear for takeoff. Thank you. Goodbye.
Classic Adventures is a series of famous hardback books. Each book comes with its own magazine to bring the home story to life. Classic Adventures.
I want to play football. Oh, I want to play badminton.
I want to do some weightlifting.
I want to do some trampolining.
The McDonald's Twisting Sports Happy Meal. Four to collect, a different one each week.
When you've got kids under your feet, and they want something quick to eat,
Just think McCain and save your day. 3 minutes here and you're awake. Quickity quick.
Microchip.
McCain may crinkle, cut or straight. Great from the box or on a plate. Trial it once and it'll be plain. Four microchips make them McCain. Quickity quick.
Microchips.
McCain microchips. Real chips. Quickity quick.
We can save 10% on our summer holiday at Glunpolly.
Get away.
You could part exchange your old house for a brand new Barrett house. Ring now on 0345 62 63 64.
Now that is smooth, but not as smooth as Belhaven Best.
Sky Television is changing. Satellite TV now gives you more choices than you ever thought possible. With over 20 channels, you could see more of the kind of things you want to see. When you want to see them. So now you can have blockbuster movies. Top sports action, 24-hour news and great family entertainment. Everything from documentaries to children's programs, plus the Premier League, live and exclusive. All at the touch of a button. Switch on to a brand new Sky.
Now for fantastic looking hair. A breakthrough by L'Oreal. New Elsev Care Mousse Non-Rinse Conditioner. After every shampoo, discover the first care conditioner in a mousse. And you don't have to rinse out. So you can detangle and perfectly condition in an instant. Now my hair is softer, shinier. Elsev Care Mousse Conditioner makes my hair light and bouncy.
New Elsev Care Mousse Conditioner by L'Oreal. Instantly beautiful hair without the rinse.
Welcome back. I'm sorry I'm late. I had a bit of an aerial incident with a goose. So Christmas has come early for somebody in Cardiff. Right, we're in Bala, Gwynedd, North Wales, for the final challenge of the evening. And it's all about shooting rapid... Excuse me. Sorry, can I help you?
Can I help you, do you mean, Matthew?
This is my challenge. I don't think I need any help.
Yeah, but this is Wales. What about the Welsh? You could try saying something in the local language.
I'm a professional, Gareth. I think I can manage a few words in Welsh.
Okay, just repeat after me. Croeso I un o'r ardaloedd prydfertha yng Nghymru.
Guess we'll just stand there and don't interrupt. We're at the Canolfan...
Canolfan Trywern.
I knew that.
Which I did.
You didn't know. The Canolfan Whitewater Rafting Centre, the ideal place for a game of basketball. Yes, I did say basketball. 7 members of staff from the centre reckon that they can score 5 baskets from their 14-foot inflatable raft while hurtling down a 1 kilometre stretch of river. They'll have 2 extra balls, just in case they miss any of the 5 baskets which are placed along the course, and they'll have 3 minutes in which to do it. This is my challenge, so let's go and meet the teams who are going to be shooting rapids while rapid shooting. Yes, come on. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Gareth Jones! And Gareth, introduce us to my challengers.
The team are made up from the National Whitewater Centre here in Bala, Gwynedd, the Canolfan Trywerin. Getting good.
Yeah.
Oh, very good. I don't know them by name, I'm afraid, but I do know a lady who does. Sarah, can you introduce the team?
Yeah, sure. This is Peter, Richard, Paul, Alex, Tony and Ian.
Welcome to the show, team. OK, Paul, how much experience has a crew got in whitewater rafting?
OK, we've all rafted all over the UK and most of us have been seen into Europe and into the States, Canada, and one of us, Tony's just come back from rafting down Mount Everest.
Really?
So you're champion rafters.
Tremendous.
You'll need to be for this challenge. Sarah, you've been nominated as a shooter.
Yeah.
Why is that?
Well, because I'm so tall.
So tall.
And I found it easiest to balance when I was running around the raft and the rest of the boys.
Have you had any practice at basketball?
A little bit, not a lot, while I was in college. But it doesn't show.
Well, you've got to get a ball in all five baskets, and you've only got the seven balls. So how are they going to control the raft to give you time enough to shoot the balls?
It's going to take all the guys' skill to get us into the slack water where the eddies are, and then they're going to place me into the basket, and then I'll shoot the balls. That's the theory of it, anyway.
OK, well, I do wish you a lot of luck, because if you don't get it, I'm the one who's going to have a forfeit, and we wouldn't want that, would we?
Yeah. Yes!
Thank you so much for your support. I do wish you a lot of luck, ladies and gentlemen. The
Canol Van Trewellyn
Whitewater Rafting Team. Thank you very much. OK, let's see what they think around the country. Keith in Cornwall, am I going to get a forfeit for this one?
Matthew, I'm sure you are, love. I'm really sorry. This is going to be no, it's never going to work. I mean, you know, they've got to shove that ball in a bit of a net, and you know how treacherous Whitewaters are. So I'm told, no.
Right, now, Dublin. Michael, this is my challenge. Do you think they'll succeed?
I don't think so, Macho. One, because it's your challenge, I'm not going to agree with you. And two, going down with a lot of fast water, trying to hit basketballs, it's a hard thing. I know basketball's a hard-all sport, so I don't think they're going to do it.
Ross, can I rely on your support for this one?
You're probably still wearing the last one that I gave you, Matthew. I would say, well, as my old gran used to say, show me some white water and I'll raft it. We can never get her out of the bathroom. It's a big yes from me this time.
Thank you very much, Ross. OK, Les, there's only Ross on my side at the moment. Are you going to back me?
Well, I've done a bit of kayaking myself, just a tiny bit, so I'm going to back you up and say yes again on this one.
Thank you very much, Les. Right, well, we're split down the middle there with our celebrities, 2-4-2 against. Let's see what our audience think here. You got your pen and paper?
I have, yes.
Here we go. Let's boldly go where presenters have never gone before. OK, I'm going to take a full team here. What's your name?
Emma.
Emma. Where are you from?
Shrewsbury.
Lovely. Now, can the Whitewater rafters do it?
Yes, I think they can.
Have you been on the course?
No, we're just about to, though.
Yes, just about.
Yes. Right.
Is this your mum and dad here?
Yeah.
Dad, what do you think?
Afraid not. No, don't
no.
think so. No.
It does look tricky to me as well.
It looks horrific.
What about you, Mother?
Oh, I don't think so either. There's a lot of water out there.
What do you think? Are they going to achieve this challenge?
Yeah, I think they can do it.
Do you think the rafters could do it?
No.
Why, is that because you want to see me do a forfeit?
Yeah.
You're so mean.
What do you reckon? Can they complete this challenge?
Well, I honestly believe they can.
There we go, Gareth.
Well, how to tell? 50% for, 50% against.
Yes, well, I've got slightly more against, but I think that's only because they want to see me do a forfeit and not because they don't think the challenge will happen. OK, so I'm going to go a split down the middle fairly evenly, 53% for and 47% against.
There's only one way of really finding out, isn't there?
Let's get them started. OK, team, on your marks. Get set.
Go.
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 I'm going.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
I'm very, very thrilled. How do you feel then?
Very tired, but it was worth it.
Absolutely. It gives me great pleasure to give you the award. And I will be honest with you now, I honestly didn't think that you were going to do it.
And I had money on you getting pied. I'm disappointed, but I'm thrilled that you guys proved that you could do something like this. Sarah, let me give you a You Bet medal, and there'll
thank
be
you.
One for every member of the team. Congratulations.
Absolutely. And thank you for a thrilling challenge. It was great. Okay, let's see what happened around the country. Keith in Cornwall, you said no, so your score stays at 154. Michael over in Ireland, you said no as well, I'm sorry, so that means that your score stays at 205. Ross, you did very well to say yes, but not quite as well during the rest of the show, so your score is 192. And Les in Jersey, well done, you said yes, you were quite right too, your score goes up to 258, which means that you are now the first winner of our new series. Well done, Les.
Excellent. Of course it was going to happen that way. I knew from the beginning.
Yes, well done, Les. Clairvoyance is always handy on this show, I think. Right, 53 of our audience were right, so let's add those 53 points to all the others that our audience got, and that gives us an audience total of 330. Let's add the celebrities' points together, and that gives us a celebrity total of 809. Let's add the audience total to the celebrity total, and that gives us a grand total of 1,139. As you know, the points get turned into pounds. And so that's a piffling amount. We're not going to triple it this year. We are, in fact, going to quadruple it. So that gives us a grand total of £4,556 for charity. And what charity shall we donate it to? Well, the six of us have had such a good holiday on this show that we've decided the money should go to charities which give holidays to disabled or disadvantaged children. And unfortunately, that's all we've got time for this week. We'll be back again next week in the studio. But for now, let's say goodbye to Keith in Cornwall.
Goodbye, Matthew from Pearpaw. Glory!
Bye, Michael Carruth in Ireland.
Bye, Matthew from Dublin. Yay!
Goodbye to Ross King in Scotland.
Yep, goodbye from Edinburgh. Yay!
Goodbye and well done to Les Hill in Jersey.
And a goodbye from St Helena, Matthew. Bye!
Goodbye from all of us here in Bala. Bye!
About whatever you feel like, right?
Guess who? Clint Eastwood is back on Scottish as Joe Kidd, Wednesday at 8.
Do you wish you had the know-how to tackle imaginative cooking? Now Prulethe brings you Confident Cooking, a step-by-step guide that grows with your confidence.
You should try.
Now you're cooking with confidence. Issue one with free binder at your newsagent now.
Mon postillon était frappé par la foudre.
Je pense que c'est le cabaretteur.
Est-ce que le cheval est à vendre?
This week, Scotland on Sunday is offering two flights for the price of one to Paris for lovers of French culture.
Come on, hen. Let's shoot the crow.
What's your Scotland on Sunday like? Find out this Sunday.
Discover the blues with a new series from your newsagent.
The thrill has gone away.
heart just like a ring in a bell. Go, go.
At only $3.99, the Blues Collection traces the musicians, the mood, but above all, the music. On CD or cassette, part one only 99p.
Retired and senior volunteer program provides opportunities for people over 50 to fill their lives positively by participating in stimulating voluntary activities. Working in groups, volunteers make new friends, more are required to undertake the services and develop RSVP. For more information, telephone 041 204 1681 during office hours, or write to RSVP, Action 2000, Box 2000, Glasgow.
On Channel 4 Garden Club, while here on Scottish romantic drama in Danielle Steele's Secrets.
I'm telling you, I can bring it in on budget. I got the figures right here.
Would I lie to the network?
Including the New York shoot.
Let me check.
Lindsay, get me casting, will you? Oh, and call Miss Quarles. Tell her I'll be 15 minutes late. Casting?
They're at lunch.
Again? Mm-hmm. Will they ever get back? Get them to call Jane Addams' agent. Who's on two?
Network.
Great, thanks. Give me an update on Zach Taylor, will you? Tony! Bill Warwick. Yes, we're about to make an offer to Bill Warwick for the role of Lance.
Yeah, lunch is confirmed at 1.
I'm not asking you to put millions of dollars behind an unknown, although it was his behind that sold all those blue jeans. Gonna be a big star, Tony. Trust me. Tony, Jane Addams was a soap star. Yeah, I know she quit the business. But anyone who spent 2 years as a Pasadena housewife would jump at the part of Amanda Strand. What? Oh, you're late for lunch. That's terrific. Talk to you later. You got Miss Quarles?
No problem. She understands.
I'll have to get back to you. Mel! Wait.
Tomorrow auditions are all set. You have candidates.
Good. Good. No, she's too old. Get those budget figures over to the network before I give Tony any reason to change his mind, will you?
Hello? Yes, Howard, I got the packet. Well, I really don't know what to say. I simply can't afford a private health insurance policy at the moment. Well, look, there's no money. Look, I can't talk now. I'm already late for lunch. I'll call you later.
Yeah, Tony. I understand. Getting a go on this project is dependent upon signing Sabrina Quarles and Zach Taylor. Tony, I understand. Don't think I can do it? Watch me. Call Lou about Jane. Nail down Harry on Bill. And for God's sake, someone track down Zach Taylor.
Don't want to keep Miss Quarles waiting.
Great of you to come, Sabina. I wasn't sure on such a short notice.
Well, I must admit, I was surprised to hear from you.
Only surprised?
Pleased. It's been a long time.
A lifetime. Well, the years haven't touched you a bit. How many since we first met? 20?
Don't remind me.
Your tea, ma'am.
You remembered?
Well, iced tea with no ice. Some things are worth remembering. I can't believe I said that.
I wanted to call you, Mel, after the accident.
I got your note. It's sweet of you. Thanks.
You okay?
Oh, yeah. It's been a long time.
That's not an answer.
Well, I have my work. That's all I have right now, but it's enough.
What about you? Your reviews on Bitter Hearts. Terrific.
Yes. Thank you. That movie made 13 cents at the box office.
Didn't you take a one-year hiatus before it all came out? I remember someone saying you just disappeared.
I didn't know anyone was looking.
Well, some of us try to keep track, you know?
Sabina, I want you to work for me.
I'd forgotten how direct you were.
It's not a feature. It's television. It's a television series.
I don't do television.
Yeah, but read this, and you will.
Manhattan.
It's a great script. The role of Eloise Markham. Made for you.
All right, I'll read it for you. That's all I promise.
That's all I ask. For now.
I'm Bill Wark, sir. I just posted bail for my wife.
Then sign here.
Have formal charges been filed?
Let's see, possession with intent to sell, solicitation, and prostitution.
I didn't think you'd show.
What was I supposed to do? Have my wife rot in jail? Why would
I didn't do any of it, Billy? Not any of it. I would set up.
Come on. Let's go home.
Where'd you get the bail money?
I borrowed it from Mark. He said I could work it off for him waiting tables. Guess I don't have to ask where the rent money went.
I'll get it back.
What?
I'll get it back.
Yeah! Selling yourself on the boulevard the first of the month? I'm sorry. I didn't mean that.
Yeah, you did. It's all right. I deserve it.
God, Sandy, don't you get it? I love you. And I can't handle you doing this to yourself. The drugs are bad enough. The prostitution? We're talking about your life. Our life. You gotta get some help, a treatment center, something.
You wanna put me away?
No. No. I just want my wife back. You are the sweetest, prettiest thing. Still the best thing in my life. Why don't you get some rest? You must be beat. Hello? This is bad news. I don't need it right now, Harry.
Well, if an offer for the role of Lance Markham in The Pilot for Manhattan is bad news, I'm in the wrong business.
Are you for real?
Yeah, I've got a freshly packed steel memo in my hands as we speak. Boy, that audition of yours must have been really something. The offer's a good one. Oh, and, Bill, the ad people, they want to promote you as some, you know, hot new sex symbol, so, you don't have to tell them that you're married.
Harry, the only reason we kept the marriage a secret was because Sandy was on that show at the time, playing a 14-year-old.
Yeah, whatever. But, let's just play it smart and keep your marital status between us. Okay?
Okay. Hang on. Harry, has the role of tomorrow been cast yet?
No, and if you're thinking about Sandy, forget it. I can't sell her, and we both know why.
She's gonna clean up. She promised, and if she got this role, it could turn it around for her. For us.
Okay, let me see what I can do. But don't expect a miracle. One a day is about all I can manage.
What'd I tell you, Deb? Everywhere you look, money.
Lord, Mr. Taylor, you could have scared a snake right out of his skin coming up on me like that.
What are you doing here?
Well, see, it's like this. I went down to the mailbox today. Now, you just go and guess what wasn't there.
I've been out of the country.
I hear tell that's why God made Federal Express.
Sorry for the delay.
Now, that's much better. I do like my business handled straight on, you know? It's better for you, it's better for us.
Mrs. Hooper. When do I get the merchandise?
Well, now, it's not near enough paid for yet. Not near enough.
Mr. Taylor, Mr. Mel Wexler's office is on the line for you.
Okay, Martin, I'll take it in the library. Would you show the ladies out? Good God, Mel. Are you psychic? I just got in.
What are you talking about? You picked your rap last week.
Oh, I know. But who wants to leave Rome at this time of year? I mean, without a lot of scratching and fighting.
Read anything good on the plane?
Not subtle, Mel.
So what do you think?
I think it's terrific.
But?
Oh, I don't know, Mel. Well, first thing, you can't afford me.
Yes, I can.
In that case, you've got yourself a deal.
One of your junior league lunches today?
Well, I wasn't feeling too well.
Great. Terrific. Set you up to make good connections, and what do? You just blow it off.
You're home early?
Fairfax Development deal just blew up in my face, I'll tell you. You just can't trust any of those foreigners.
Dan?
But I know. It's gonna make me feel a whole lot better.
Yeah, well, I'm not feeling very well.
Well, then maybe this will make us both feel a whole lot better.
Dan, Alexa's gonna be coming home from school.
What the hell is this? What the hell is that?
It's a script for a pilot for a series that I've been offered.
Well, you're not doing it.
Dan, it's a chance to work with Mel Wexler. The part was made for me. It's something I could do really well.
Let's face it. There's only one thing you do well, and that's the one thing that I'm keeping for myself.
No. No, there's no insurance. Look, that doesn't matter. That doesn't matter. You just do what you have to do, and I will find the money somehow.
Yes, just like that.
Yes, just like that.
I can't believe it. What are you doing to me? Do you realize I spent the entire day preparing arguments for each of your reasons for saying no?
Oh, dear. And here I am cheating you out of all that. I'm so sorry.
Like hell you are.
Just out of interest, why did you think I'd turn you down?
Your independence, your reclusiveness, which are legendary. Your snobbishness about television, the weekly grind, money. Please stop me before I talk you back out of it. Why now?
Things change.
You don't. You're as exciting as you were the first day I met you.
We were good for each other back then, weren't we?
Yeah. Well, I know what you're thinking. But it's been 4 years, you know, since I lost Ellen and the kids. And yes, I did spend most of those 4 years blaming myself for their deaths, or at least not being on that same plane with them, dying with them.
No.
I don't feel like that anymore. I still have my memories. Oh, yeah. It'd be awful nice to start living a real life again.
That's the hard part, isn't it?
I'll see you to your door.
Oh, no, please, don't go there. Hardly my house on Roxbury, is it?
Why didn't you sell that? It was a nice house.
Yes. Yes, it was.
Sabrina, are you all right?
I will be if Manhattan's a hit. Thank you for everything.
Sabrina, business aside, I'd like to see you again.
You know, I'd quite like that too.
There is only one chocolate that feels like silk. The experience is silk. The chocolate is galaxy.
Can surf powder clean so well and give you this much more washing for your money? Easy. Surf Now comes in a range of bags, so it costs you less. And right now, you get 15% more powder. Surf. Tackle stains, cuts costs.
You already know you don't need muscles to use Mr. Muscle Non-Smear Window Cleaner. Now we'll prove Mr. Muscle No-Rinse Bathroom Cleaner is just as tough. Mr. Muscle loves the jobs you hate.
Pick up the new Index catalogue this week and you could win a new Rover Metro. Index, the catalogue shop.
Your teeth are under constant attack from plaque. So are their foundations, your gums. Fortunately, there are lines of defense. Brushing with McLean's fights the plaque that causes tooth decay. It also helps protect your gums from disease. For healthy teeth and gums, attack plaque with McLean's.
Labradors are very, very hearty eaters. And they need a good, hearty meal.
Top breeder Glenda Crook recommends Pedigree Chum Select Cuts.
It looks really appetizing. It's full of big, meaty chunks covered in a lovely gravy, which is vitamin enriched. They really get the teeth into it and they wolf it down. It looks good, it smells good, and they just love it. They're full of energy and they look really great on it. I think it's the best meaty food for my dogs.
Pedigree Chum Select Cuts. Top breeders recommend it.
Yes, Martin, it's a tracksuit.
I can see that, Dad, but what's it doing on you?
It's part of my new healthier lifestyle. First step, Kellogg's Bran Flakes.
Kellogg's Bran Flakes?
Yeah, they're high in fibre, low in fat.
They taste great. So this new lifestyle of yours means that as well as eating Kellogg's Bran Flakes, you'll be jogging to the newsagents every day?
Yep.
Well, one step at a time, Martin.
Kellogg's Bran Flakes, a step in the right direction.
Starting tomorrow in the Daily Mail, ITN's war correspondent Michael Nicholson tells the heart-rending true story of Natasha, the little orphan he rescued from the nightmare of Bosnia. Relive their extraordinary flight to freedom. Share in the tears and laughter as she came to terms with her new life. And read how his wife and family learned to love the little stranger in their midst. Natasha's story moved him enough to rescue her. It will move you too. Starting tomorrow, only in the Daily Mail.
Sex crimes. A little of what nature requires, taken to excess.
Cracker coming soon on Scottish.
The mechanic says you need new brakes.
Yeah.
You're so gullible. You believe anything anybody tells you. Look, the brakes are just fine. Now, if you don't trust them, why don't you try staying home for a change? Then it won't matter if they're good or not. What the hell is that?
You said you wanted your eggs over easy.
Right. Not like rocks.
I'll make you some others.
No, no, please. Don't bother. I'll get something downtown.
Morning, Daddy.
How about a goodbye kiss from my best girl?
You aren't going to stay for breakfast?
Well, I'll tell you what. Why don't you grab your books? We'll have breakfast together and I'll drop you off at school.
Oh, great.
Alexa, honey, I just made the waffles you asked for.
Yeah, well, I'd rather eat with Daddy, okay?
See you tonight.
I'll be home for lunch.
I'm sorry to call you at home, but I just wanted to let you know, if they still want me for that part, I'll take it. Yeah, I mean it. New York location shooting and all.
A former series star gets arrested for possession and soliciting? Damn it, though. If you called me, maybe I could have kept it out of the papers.
I thought I could handle it myself. She's my wife.
A drug addict is nobody's wife. So where is she now?
She hasn't been home for 2 days.
Sure, which explains why she blew off the audition I set up for.
So, who am I reading with?
The last of the finalists. Her name's Gabrielle Smith. Smile.
Now you're mad at me because I said I love you?
Lance, don't you understand? The cruelest words I have ever heard are, I love you.
Tomorrow.
Yeah, all right, thank you, Bill. Gabby, would you wait outside, please?
Sure.
What's your background?
Raised in the East, went to Yale. Been out here a couple of years. Small parts, commercials, that's all I know.
Could our ingenue have a past?
Well, no mystery. Never hurt. Let's run it by the network.
You're very good, you know.
So are you.
I just want this part so bad. I pulled every string to get it on audition, called in every favor. I even had my hair redone to look like Tamara.
What a pro.
You still got those winter clothes of yours from back east?
I think so.
Good. We leave for New York in 3 weeks. You're gonna need them.
Yes.
Bernie. Paul. Steve. Next time, tone it down a little. This lady's beautiful enough. She doesn't need any help.
Thank you.
Oh, sir, how you do go on.
Give me half a chance, please. Enjoyed our dinner together last night.
Only last night? Not the night before?
Yeah, and the night before that. How many has it been?
Gordon's counting.
Seven?
Eight.
What about tonight, my place?
Should I bring wine?
Yeah, bring wine, candles. Just bring yourself. That would be nice. This gets out, they'll think I slept with you to get the deal. How about this weekend? Palm Springs. My house.
Sounds lovely, but I'm going to San Francisco in the morning.
I love fog. I'll come with you.
No. I need to be alone.
Oh. Deep dark secret.
Hi, how you doing? How about a vodka martini dry on the rocks, and for the lady, a white wine spritzer? We haven't met. I'm Zach Taylor.
Jordan.
Bill Warwick. Lance. I've been a fan of yours for a very long time, Mr. Taylor. I've always wanted a career, a life like yours.
Be careful what you wish for.
Sabina. This is fantastic.
Of course it is. It's the one you had your wardrobe people send over.
Shh, not in front of the children. Everybody, Sabina Quarles. Sabina, you know Zach Taylor, I think.
We did a play together ages ago.
We were just children.
Oh. Now I know why no one in this town has an unkind word for you.
How are you, Sabina? And this is Jane Addams, who plays Amanda.
How do you do? I'm looking forward to working with you.
I will make your life a living hell.
It's in the script, Jane. It's in the script.
Yeah, Bill. It's Bill Warwick, your stepson, Lance.
Well, I can see now why they changed it to stepson. No one would ever believe you're old enough to be my natural mother.
Oh. If you didn't put him up to this, he deserves a bonus. Well, considering your looks, more screen time.
Gabrielle Smith, your daughter, Tamara.
Hi, it's nice to meet you. My parents were big fans of yours.
How lovely. I thought you said you'd cast someone pretty. Good for you.
Let's get a real drink, shall we? Stinger would be appropriate. Can't take any drink.
I heard she's difficult to work with.
Who?
Our Miss Quarles.
Isn't everybody?
Beautiful, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
I thought I heard Mel say that you were coming with your husband tonight.
Oh, he's out of town on business. My daughter's on a sleepover at a girlfriend's. It's so strange. I never do anything without my family.
How old's your daughter?
Oh, Alexa's nearly 16. And she's beautiful. Well, mercifully, she hasn't shown any signs of being interested in show business. Well, actually, she said she'd like to become a lawyer. I think I must be boring you to tears.
Not at all. No, in fact, you're very much like I thought you were going to be. You're just like your character in Secret Sorrows.
You watch the soaps?
What else is there to do on location? I mean, it got to be a habit after a while. You know, you were so terrific on that show. Why did you leave?
Well, it was getting hard managing the family and the show. And Dan, that's my husband, thought I was sorry to leave.
I'm sorry to see you go.
All right. Now, I have been threatened, bribed, blackmailed, and bullied by someone among you who shall be nameless to keep my remarks to a minimum.
Sir.
So I will be brief.
Impossible.
A. I'm thrilled to have you all on board. B. I am proud to be associated with you. C. We're going to have a hell of a lot of fun over the next few months. And D, with any luck, over the next few years.
Here.
Now, none of us are related in any way. Certainly not through blood. But we are a family. And we're a family that is bound together by respect, talent, trust, and a passion for what we do. But a family has rules, and here they are. Learn your lines, hit your marks, be on time, stay out of trouble, and if the show's a hit, don't renegotiate your contract. So, as titular head of the family, Patriarchus Supremus, I wish you good luck, Godspeed, and welcome to Manhattan.
Manhattan.
Give me that. There you go.
Oh, Billy. Hi.
All right, that's it. Everybody out, now.
Come on, Billy, we just have a little party.
You don't come home for a week. You don't call. I'm going half crazy looking for you now. All right, get your sleazy ass off my couch and get out of my house before I call the cops.
Billy, you're hurting me.
You're hurting me.
Are you coming?
Sure.